Penn State has been waiting all week for this one. Get ready, folks. The opening kickoff is finally here. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. He guns it left side. Almost intercepted.
This just shows you that you don't need to be sacking the quarterback to disrupt the passing game.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. He's on the run. Good game there on the quarterback scramble.
You know, I really like the decision to tuck it and run here. He waited and found no one open, so instead of throwing it away, he just took it upfield for himself.
And they got it.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
And that's three and out. Nothing going on that series. Penn State's coaching staff so confident they know they've got a guy that's one of the best running backs in the country and that they can just play their game and not worry about the fact they're on the road.
Well, Brett, his big play ability not only can give you big chunks of yards on the road, but more importantly, it can quiet this atmosphere and allow the quarterback in this offense to just getting back and just being able to run and be able to communicate. And I think that's a big challenge for this team. So look for his big play ability to maybe even out the atmosphere and give this offense a chance to be able to execute.
First and 10. Ball on the 39.
Black five. X. Motion. Seven.
Play action. He sails it long. Doesn't get there. That one sailed on him.
He wanted his receiver, but I think that may have slipped out of his hands.
That makes it second and 10.
Hey, check Mike 39. Check Mike 39. Go!
That's a great tackle at the 35. It's third down and 14 yards to go now after that setback by the sack. So that'll make it fourth down.
It's a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. From the 15. And down he goes at the 30-yard line. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. They go to the left for a nice game.
Makes it second and six.
From their own 34-yard line. Second down.
Let's go!
He scrambled. Tackle made at the 41. Taken down around the 48-yard line. From the 48-yard line, first down. He's tackled at the 45.
That's a gain of three on the play. That'll make it second and seven.
Yeah.
tailback, and he's met in the backfield.
That's a loss of 3 yards on the play. That brings up third and 10.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 38.
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make a play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
He really got a hold of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. After a decent pickup.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That'll make it second and 4.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first.
Hey, check Mike 39. Check Mike 39.
Here we go, here we go.
And he's tackled after positive yardage.
I'm a huge fan of the play-action pass in college football because the play-action, it really puts a lot of pressure on a defense. The defense gets caught up and concerned about the running game, and it puts them out of position, and it makes the throwing lanes for the quarterback and the windows that he's trying to find much easier to find for a quarterback and the receivers to pick up big yards like we just saw there.
What a run by the quarterback.
Boy, this guy is dangerous. He can hurt you by running or throwing. There you can see how talented he is as a runner. The play breaks down. He didn't panic or get flustered. He just tucks it in and picks up a nice gain.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 34. And he tackles him hard at the 33. To convert here on another third down. And they make the stop at about the 25-yard line. It's going to be fourth and inches after that long pickup on third down.
Boy, what a throw by the quarterback. Almost equally excellent catch by the receiver, but the defense topped them both by coming up with a stop.
We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks.
Hey, check Mike 39. Check Mike.
Red 2.
Green 9. Green.
And he carries the ball for a nice game.
That's a gain of 4 on the play.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive.
Four down. Hey, check Mike 39. Check Mike 39.
Dog 4. Orange, go.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 21-yard line.
Hey, check Mike 39. Check Mike 39.
Now he's flushed and they got him.
That's a loss of 4 yards on the play. That brings up third and 14.
This is the 11th play of this drive. Quick strike and he drops it.
Well, the quarterback has to be careful here not to leave his receiver so vulnerable like that.
He took a licking right there.
They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. Penn State could take the lead with this field goal. It's up, looks long enough, and he got it.
Boy, he had plenty of distance there and pushed it through. Very impressive leg strength.
3-0, Penn State. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Brought down around the 40-yard line.
That's not everyday speed you're talking about with this guy. This is a unique burst combined with a really impressive field vision.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 40. Scrambling, and they got him.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
From their own 39-yard line, second down. Throws it away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Going deep. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
Number six was the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it fourth and 10.
He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. Pretty good job by the return man there. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Penn State is up by 3. Takes a handoff. Tackled for a loss. Their own 25-yard line. It's second down.
Black five, black five. Kill, kill, kill.
Open receiver dropped.
That is textbook pass defense. As soon as the ball hit the receiver's hands, he was all over it.
To that quickly, and he's taken down at the 36-yard line.
That'll make it 4th and 2.
Talk about a booming punt. My goodness.
Again, it's about stressing special teams. That is why a lot of head coaches usually run these units. It's because field position is just so important in the game.
Scrambling around. Tackle at the 23.
Good coverage by the defense, but they have to be aware of this quarterback's tendency to scramble around and pick up some yards.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
I think you got to give credit to the big boys up front there. They're able to get this back to room that he needed.
He's going to try and scramble. Has some daylight. And down he goes around the 37-yard line. From their own 37-yard line. It's first down.
Here we go.
corner. And he's tackled at the 48. First down. Quick throw. Tackle made at the 35.
Number three on the tackle at the 35-yard line. That brings up second and nine.
The Boilermakers taking their first time out of the half. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Here's the halfback, and he's brought down hard behind the line.
That'll make it 39.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Try a long field goal here. Purdue is down three and looking to tie it up. Kick is up. It's got the distance. And he just drilled it from long range. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
You know, we're getting so used to pinball football with a lot of points. Kind of fun to see defenses play this way.
Kind of refreshing, isn't it? I mean, every single week we call games and you're seeing scores in the 30s and 40s. This is one of those low-scoring games. Which offense will get that big break? Eventually, it could be the team that wins it.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum. So as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays.
They bring him down.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. So we've played two quarters. 3-3 tie.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollock here, completely locked in on that first half. Defense has been in total control in the first half, and you'd think maybe the offense's confidence was shaken. But if you want to look at the entire team picture, David, how big a deal is it for an offense to know, look, if we can just put together one, maybe two good scoring drives, our defense has got our back?
Well, a lot of times when you know you have a defense, it's great, too, is you build your offense around it. And when I say that, why do I need to take chances? You know, if it's third and long, I don't mind throwing a five-yard pass, and if I break a tackle, I get a first down. I mean, don't put my defense that's dominant, that's great, in a bad position, and you can afford to be more conservative. You see it every single year. What do we always talk about here at ESPN? We talk about you defense wins championships, and that's how you win ball games. And you see it consistently unfold. So if I'm building an offense, let's just not put my great dominant defense in a bad position.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes three or four axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
Reese and David, I know you're jealous. This is the kind of games you guys like to do. And that's Thursday night. This is the big show.
And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Throws complete, big loss. 5-yard loss on the play.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
Second down, and they've got 15 for the first down. Ball on their own 20.
Go four! Blue 20! Go!
Delayed handoff, and he's not going to get back to the line. Taken down at the 50.
That makes it first and 10.
Now it's first and 10 with a defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. They get nice yardage on that run.
Gain 5 yards. That makes it second and six.
Four down. Hey, check Mike 39. Check Mike 39.
Dog four. And he's immediately tackled.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
From the 36-yard line, first down. Fired quickly, and he's got his man. He's tackled at the 25-yard line.
First down.
Man left, man left. Four down. Hey, check Mike 39. Check Mike 39. Dog four. And go.
They'll bring him down at the 17-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
Hey, check Mike 39. Check Mike 39. Here we go.
The 10 makes it to the 5. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
It's the 9th play of the drive.
And then 2.
Throws it out right to the running back. So they hit the halfback on the short pass for the touchdown.
Boy, what a great story. They've talked about the commitment that this guy has made in practice to make himself a more complete player. He has spent many extra hours catching ball after ball, and right there it paid off.
And he converts the extra point. A 9-play, 75-yard drive. And they put up 7 points.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. He heaves it deep. Oh, so close to breaking it. So after the big pass play, we've got a first down. Some room. They go to the left for a nice game.
the stop at the 15-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards.
It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker.
Mike 40.
And they'll get him in the backfield.
Call it a loss of 1 yard on the play. Fourth down.
The kick is up, and it's through the uprights. They line up to kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. And they can forget about returning this one. Purdue's not going to back down from anybody, Herbie. I guess at least not today.
No, not today. They've played with a chip on their shoulder. They've stood toe-to-toe with the big boys, and I don't think they're finished yet.
The quarterback did a really good job in the last drive of finding his receivers in space, and I bet he'll be looking to do the same thing again.
Penn State holds a 4-point lead, and he makes it out to about the 27-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
From their own 27-yard line, second down. Push him out at the 37.
That makes it first and 10.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Fires quickly to the tight end. He's hit and taken down.
Number 39 with the tackle at the 34-yard line. That will make it 77.
Gains his way to the 20-yard line. So the run goes for a big first down.
The offensive line opened up some nice lanes to run through as well. Nice play.
First and 10. Ball on the 20-yard line.
Green nine.
Go. Never really had a shot. They were on him almost as soon as he took the handoff.
Penn State is up by 4.
Red, two.
Gets it. He's in space. Big play, and it's first and goal. So with one quarter remaining, the Nittany Lions in front, 10-6.
That makes it first and goal.
Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. Tackled after a decent run up the gut.
Good for a gain of 6 yards. That brings up second.
This is the ninth play of this drive.
Let's set a tone, fellas. Let's set a tone.
They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. Touchdown, Penn State. Tacks on the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals,
I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
Boy, the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack. Somehow, he's able to throw the ball away.
It's second and 10. Ball on their own 25. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. It to the 47.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. He's out of bounds at about the 49. So the pass was complete for a gain of 2 on the play, and that's good for a first down.
Nice play there to move the chains and keep the drive rolling.
Here we go. Black 90. Black 90.
Here they come. And he's tackled right away.
That'll bring up second and 3.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Keep 15.
Mike 40.
Here we go. Black 68. Black 68. Run.
Complete. He's got room. Brought down at the 34. Complete. He's hammered. It's second and 7. Ball on the 30. Just under 3 to go in regulation. And he's taken down at the 19. Quickly to the tailback. Tackle at the 12-yard line. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
The offensive coordinator right now is very happy with the execution. That's the 5th first down on this drive alone. So the big thing is when you have this kind of drive going, you don't want to end it in a field goal. Now, you want to focus on trying to put the football into the end zone.
And down he goes at the 2-yard line.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That brings him second and goal.
And this is the 12th play of the drive. Strike to the receiver, touchdown. Big, big touchdown through the air, and now it's a 1-score game. Well, they're going to try for the 2-point conversion. He scrambled. They don't get it. So a 12-play, 75-yard drive. And they get 6 points on the board after failing the 2-point conversion. Brought down at the 41-yard line. A score here might effectively end this one.
just under two to go in the game. And he's tackled around the 41-yard line. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
Good job by the junior linebacker to read the run and limit the play to a short game.
Around the 39-yard line. A 2-yard run by the halfback.
I feel the corner position is really one of the hardest to play. So when I see a young player like this make a play like that, it's impressive.
He's taken down at the 32-yard line. So close, but they fall short of the first down.
You got to throw the ball a little deeper next time. Don't take any chances of coming up short.
It has the distance, and it's good. Like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Goes out of bounds
around the 32-yard line.
From their own 32-yard line. Second down. He's under pressure, and he just gets rid of it.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Hey, Mike. Hey, no, let's switch the mic right here. We'll go Mike 40, Mike 40.
Let's go!
That's a great tackle at the 37.
Brad, you can really feel and sense the energy coming from the sidelines right now. You know how important it is to pick up first downs. And the coaches right now are showing the excitement that they have and yelling out the next play for the offense. But clearly, the offensive coordinator very happy about the execution on that last play.
Caught sideline, and he stays in. And the big pickup through the air has made it first and 10. Just over a minute left. Out of bounds at the 23-yard line. Fires to the end zone, picked off. He steps up and makes a big turnover.
Yeah, he just made a huge play right there. He knew what was coming all along.
We're down to our final minute of this ball game. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. Takes a knee. And that should do it. Our final tally in this one. Penn State 20, Purdue 12. The Boilermakers. That brings this broadcast to a close. 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.